Obama is very proud to present Russell Brauer.
Sometimes I feel like a ship in a bottle, lost on a corner on somebody's shelf. Ship-shaped and unborn and perfect and useless, a copy of someone who could be myself. Somebody made and then I will know if I'm sinking or swimming, and I'll take my chances on the wind and the
sings mostly ballads. And we're talking new. This is Richard Danley, my and we have about 15 songs of the Great American Songbook genre. And some little stories about my life as a singer, as a dog owner, as a blah 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 in New York City. And we're gonna start in a couple of songs. I'll sing two for you now, and then I'm going to tell you about my audition for America's Got Talent. Okay. This is Sunny Boy, which is a song made famous by Hal Jolson.
I'm upon my knees, Sunny Boy. You are only free, Sunny Boy. You've no way of knowing, I've no way of showing what you mean to me, Sonny Boy. When there are gray skies, forget about sent from heaven, and I call your word. You made a heaven right here for me. Thank you.
So, I auditioned for America's Got Talent a couple of years ago, and it was also a very cold winter's day in January, and they said, show up at about 9 o'clock, but you should get there a little earlier, so I got there at 6:30. Because I'm always Peter Prom. Guess what? There was a line, 4 square blocks around the Javits Center. It was so crowded. And we waited outside until 9 o'clock in the cold. And then finally at 9 o'clock, they bring us into this big cavernous room that looked like Ellis Island. You know, give me your poor and your needy and your tired and your weary and huddled masses yearning to be famous, I guess. And so then, this is 9 o'clock, I didn't get to audition until 4 in the afternoon. So you're like lying there dying. And they brought us in, I think there were about 10 of us in a room, like a lineup, you know. And there were people of various ages, mostly singers, and most of them very good. Oh, there were some really good people. We got to each sing, do our little piece, maybe the whole thing, but, you know, they didn't say a word about any of us until this one little boy they got to. And let me show you this visual. This is what he did. And he made these farting noises, and it was supposed to be on pitch, and sort of sang a little bit with them. Well, they went gaga. Where did I go wrong all these years? You know, so they just, oh, we're going to send you to Hollywood, we want to take you, and all the other singers and myself were looking at each other. So in closing, I'd like to say I'm not so sure America has talent. Liza Minnelli, and she sang this for me. or for loving. I'd love to manage you because I want a second career. Do you think you'd be interested? I said, would I? So I need all the help I can get. So she said, you have a tape. And I had this tape that I made, and I gave it to her. And then 2 weeks later, she died. Then I was shopping at the Colony Music Store. True story. I was shopping at the Colony Music Store, which used to be at 49th and Broadway, you know, and it was open 24 hours, and it was really wonderful. I mean, I would, you know, if you had to get a song, you know, at 3 in the morning, you ran down there and got it in the moment of obsessive compulsive disorder. And so I met a woman there. We were both shopping for music, and, you know, it turns out we were both singers. And, oh, really? Blah, blah, blah. And she said she had a radio show. I said, oh, that's nice. And I said, what kind of stuff? And I said, well, that's what I sing, the Great American Songbook. But she said, you have a tape. So I said,
yeah.
So I gave her my tape, and then she called me. She said, I'd love to have you as a guest on the show. I said, oh, that's great. So call me in a couple of weeks. So I called her back in a couple of weeks, and the outgoing message on her tape machine said, funeral services for Shirley so-and-so. Then I went down and auditioned for a place called the Cookery, which was at 2nd Avenue and 10th Street. It was a very important room at the time. A man named Barney Josephson was the one who was the proprietor. He liked me, he said. And he said, you know, I will maybe have you there in the fall. Let's see. Well, he was being cagey about it because he sold the place. But I didn't know that then. And he wasn't sure either. But the person who kept the door open there, the big actor, was Alberta Hunter. And she was a woman who was very, very famous in the 20s and 30s and 40s. And then she quit. She became a nurse. And then in the 80s, when she was like 85 years old, she had this second career. And she was killing them in there. I mean, just fantastic. She was so good. So I went to see her, of course. And then I thought, you know, I'm going to send my tape to Alberta Hunter and ask her if she wanted a good word for me with Barney Josephson. So you know where this is going. Dead. And that's how I killed two Shirleys and one Alberta in the demo tape that I made in the 1980s. Now, we have two from Peter Pan.
I know a place where dreams are born, and time is never planned. It's not of any chance you must find in your heart, never, never land. It might be miles beyond the moon, or right here where you stand. Just keep an open mind, and then suddenly you'll find never, never land. You'll have a lot of treasure if you stay there, more precious far than gold. For if you can find your way there, you will never, never grow old. So come with me when dreams are born, and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things, and your heart will fly on wings forever, in never, never land. Have a treasure if you stay there, more precious than gold. For if you can find your way there, you will never, never grow. Now, when afraid you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well. That long ago this song was sung to me. Now it's just a distant memory. From a distant past, I used to know.
I came into the techno world kicking and screaming. I am the Lord's biggest Luddite. You know, I just had no interest in it at all. And I had to, you know, get savvy because I made a CD and the guy said, you have to listen to this and the other thing, you got to get this. So I got myself all set up and, you know, I kind of like it. I mean, some of it I like. A lot of it I find very confusing. I just don't do it very well at all. So I'll give you an example. I joined Facebook, and of course, I love YouTube, you know, and I can pick up my email, I can open the machine, I can close the machine. And Facebook, there was a whole new bunch of abbreviations you had to use. And like BTW is by the way, and then there's LMAO, which means laughing your ass off, and then there's LOL, which means laugh out loud. But guess what I thought it meant? I thought it meant lots of love. So I sent all these people, and they would say, oh, I'm just announcing that my mother died yesterday, blah, 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 blah. You know where this is going. I said, oh, I'm so sorry for your loss. LOL, run call. LOL, run call. I'm sure I lost, you know, some of my Facebook. What's the matter with me? So then, here's another a very good example of what I'm talking about. I joined this thing called Nextdoor, you know, Nextdoor. So it's like for blocks, you know, that are near you, 102nd and 103rd or whatever, so that your neighbors can connect with you and you can sell things to them or help them or, well, they should know it's like in a neighborhood. So but that sounds good. A friend of mine said, Russell, join this, you know, I'm a dog walker, maybe they'll get more walks or anything. So I joined Nextdoor, and inadvertently, I pushed the wrong button, and I invited half of North America to join with me. And I was getting calls and angry emails from people saying, why did you ask me to join this? It's so far away. You know, my cousin called me from California. And my friends called me from New Jersey. How do you want to join? I didn't know. And so somebody stopped me on the street, you know. And she said, do you want me to join it? No, I didn't even know that I was doing it. So it shows you I am just terrible. I love that with these computer things. So let's do another couple of songs. Oh, this is a gorgeous song. An old ballad called Poor Butterfly.
Poor Butterfly. Blossoms waiting.
Oh,
I'm going to tell you a story about my experiences shopping in shopping centers in New York City. Now, I don't know how many of you are actually from New York City. I was raised in the suburbs, and in the suburbs, there are very large aisles in all the supermarkets. You can skate through them or whatever, and they have so many more things. But here, we have these tiny little aisles. And I mean, I kid you not, they're like 4 feet wide. And so I finished my dog walking chores in the middle of the day around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I go to this one, the Associated in 97th in Amsterdam. And that seems to be the time when all the senior citizens go in, you know. So people come in. I mean, it's the high point of their day. You can tell they're so happy to be there. This is a great social occasion, you know. So they stop in the aisles. They talk to each other. And sometimes they're in wheelchairs, and they're pushed by their certified nurse's assistant, and then they bring a shopping cart with them, and then they bring a store shopping cart with them, so they each have their little parade of stuff with them. And okay, right? So this one lady, oh, God, she turned my page. I felt so bad for her, though. So I'm waiting to get into the store, and it had one of those doors that's, like, sensitive and bangs you or something. So I'm, excuse me, may I? And she said to me, young man, I am 89 years old, and I'm going to take my time and read this circular. I have lived a long time, and I owe it to myself to take my time, and you're not going to get up in front of me. Blah, 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 blah. She went on and I said, absolutely, you're so right. So finally, I got, you know, she read the circular or whatever, I got around her. And then I saw her again in another part of the store. And I said, pardon me, can I get through over here? Young man, I am 93 years old. She gained for you. 93 years old. And I'm going to read the label of contents on this soup and take my time, and no one is going to stop me. Okay, fine. So she read the label, I got what I needed, you know, and I'm like, okay, 20 minutes later, finally I got my shopping done, trying to be really nice to all the older people, I'm right around the corner from that myself, and, you know, I said, you know, be kind, and I was trying very hard. So I get into line, and guess who I'm behind? Okay, so she's 15 cents short with a cashier. I know I have those 2 pennies in here somewhere, you know. So I said to the cashier, what's wrong? You know, so she said she's 15 cents short. So I said, let me give you the 15 cents. Really, it's on me. Oh, my God. She read me the right. She said, I, young man, am 103 years old. And I have never had to rely upon a man in my life for anything. And I'll be goddamned if I'm going to let you pay for anything. Okay. So what I felt was, Jesus, she went from 89 to 103 in 20 minutes. I hope she got home. She could be a pile of dust or something on Amsterdam Avenue. Good night. Where are we? People. Oh, yeah.
Feeling deep in your soul says you are.
another thing, Omar. I just have a thing for this. This is called Little Girl Blue. And I first heard Judy Garland do it. It had a big influence on me. And it's just a beautiful song. So. Sit there and count your fingers. What can you do? You're through. Sit there and count your little fingers. Unlucky little girl blue. Sit there and count the raindrops falling on you. And I have my brother and my parents, my
parents in a load with us. We had fun. We used to sing, "We ain't got a barrel of money. We may look ragged and funny." And we sang Moon River and just, you know, stuff, and with varying degrees of musical talent, of course. But we had a lot of fun with that. But I guess I wanted to also tell you about this one experience I had with a therapist. In the 1980s, I was in therapy with about 10 different people. I fired them at the drop of a hat, you know. So this one therapist, she was so new-agey, and annoyed the shit out of me. And she said, "All you have to do for yourself, Russell, is show up." So I was doing these horrible jobs, one after another, temp working, and I was the lousiest typist in the world, so I got everything that was the lowest stuff, like filing and shredding papers and, you know, answering the phones and stuff like this. I was getting like $7 an hour. But the really awful part was, I remember her saying, "All you have to do is show up." So, like, I had to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and take a shower and wash my hair and dry my hair and iron a shirt and make lunch and put on a suit and put on a tie and put on a jacket and make lunch. And, and then I had a 20-minute walk to the subway, and I was on the number 6 line. So it was like 3 different trains would go by before you could even get in the goddamn train. So this was like, it took 3 hours, you know. So I showed up. I showed up at the work, you know.
Yeah.
And then, you know, they had me sit down and, you know, do something really dull. So I called this therapist and I said, "You know, I'm really angry with you. It took me all this time just to get ready. So by the time I got here, I was so goddamn tired. I felt like I should be paid for the whole goddamn day just for showing up." And I said, "You told me all I had to do was show up. And you're wrong. Click." And that's how I thought it was funny. But I just want to say this cute little thing. I saw on Facebook the other day, it was a very cute little cartoon about these two women are sitting around, and this woman said, "I made a New Year's resolution." This is so like myself. And she said, "My New Year's resolution," she's talking to her friend, "is never to stick my foot in my mouth again." And she turns to her friend and she said, "And I bet yours is to go on a diet and lose lots of weight." If there's a right way to do it, there's a right way to screw it up. Nobody does it like me. Okay. Let's do Moon River.
Moon River.
I wanted to acknowledge some people. First of all, Sidney Meyer, who booked me here, is always so lovely to me. Very nice man. And I don't know. Are you here, Sidney? Oh, hi, Sidney. And the lighting, you know, I always say to her, you know, just blind me. You know, it doesn't matter. You know, I can't see anything up here. I can feel you. I know you're here. But I can't see you. And that's fine. So the other thing I wanted to say is I'll be back here February 21st. And let's see, Lorinda. I was the worst table waiter in the whole world. I spilled a whole tray of drinks on someone. You know, I was the worst table waiter in the world. I must have had 1,500 temp jobs. It was awesome. Anyway, the other thing I wanted to thank Richard Danley for playing. So we're going to do, oh yes, after I finish, I'll be outside waiting to shake your hand. So we're going to do something from me called If You Walked Into My Life. I just needed a sip.
Thank you.
Where's that boy with a bugle? My little love, who is old, is my first romance. Where's that boy with a bugle? And why did I ever buy him those damn long pants? Did he need a stronger hand? We need a lighter touch. Was I soft or was I tough? Did I give too much? Or did I give it all? At the moment that he needed me, did I ever turn away? Would I be there if he called? Walk into my life today. With there's a little dark, with nights a little wild, did I overstress my forgot to say? When I think of one or two, if he walked into my life today, should I blame the times I pampered him, or blame the times I bought him? What a shame I never really found the boy before I lost. Were the years a little fast? Was his world a little free? Was there too much of a crowd? All too lost and loud, and not enough of me? And I'll ask. away. Would I make the same mistake if he walked into my life? Today, if that boy with the bugle walked into my life. Today,
thank you so much and have a great night.